सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरंपरां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विदधाति पूर्वं यो वेदागश्च प्रहिणोति तस्मै तगुंह देवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेश नमो मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्लोक्यत्व निर्मलं अपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहन्नमत्वन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। There are some missing words here. I mean, incomplete words rather, not missing words. The letters, some letters I filled in. I still have to look, cross check with the printed book if I have that. Let me open that. What's the 216 you're looking at? You're yet to start with 216. Yeah, okay, there also it's the same thing. I was hoping that the scan is different. It isn't, it's the same. In fact, this is the PDF that I printed. Okay, so in the progression, we have seen the definitions of pramata, pramana, prameya, and in the chaitanyas, the division wise, you've seen, just go to the progression. So it started with tattva drishti's question. Everything is started with tattva drishti's question because it's a dialectic, just like Krishna Arjuna samvada in Gita. Here also, as long as doubts are there, the teaching continues. Avagati paryantam jnanam. So pramatru, pramana, pramiti and prameya chaitanya divisions have been looked at. Why? Because there was a purva paksha as to how can you have pramana, prameya and such bedhas. Pramata cannot be different because everything is chaitanya. So that was the question there. Therefore, the explanation. So initially, what exactly is pramana when it was defined? So prama was defined. Pramanam was defined. In fact, pramana was defined as what? Prama, karanam, pramanam. First, various types of prama are looked into. Then when you say prama, karanam, pramanam, Karanam also has to be known. Prama is known. Karana has to be known. So Karana definitions are looked at. Karana Lakshanam. So in their example is Pratyaksha. Pratyaksha is not the only Prama. There are six types of Shadvidha Prama where Smriti is not included. So Smriti was set aside. In one interpretation, or some people consider, some philosophers think that Smriti is also included, but then in Siddhanta, Smriti is not included. There can be Yatharta Anubhava, which is Smriti, which has led to Smriti, and there can be Ayatharta Anubhava, which has led to Smriti. Therefore, Smriti, one type of Smriti may be valid, but still it is not a Pramana. Then, what is Karana? Karana Lakshana. Lakshana is definition. So, some people may be lost as to what is, how did we land here into details. So, if you are getting confused, then as I suggested, either you read through the titles of the Avarta, they are very clear. Then you'll know how the progression is, or make a note in your own words as to what follows what. So, what is happening here is Karana Lakshana is given for Pratyaksha as an example. So, Pratyaksha Pramanam, for Pratyaksha Prama, Pratyaksha Pramana is Karana. Similarly for others. And then, what is Prama there? Prama that we have seen. What is Pramana we have seen? What is Karana we have seen? There, what types, what is Karana in that? Karana is Karana. What kind of Karana? Sadharana or Asadharana? So we have looked into Sadharana, Asadharana. So each word is being analyzed. This is Mimamsa. Mimamsa is Shabda Mimamsa, Vakya Mimamsa. And Vedanta is Uttara Mimamsa. So we have to analyze the words, because Jnana will take place only through words. So it has to be analyzed. Each word has to be understood. And Jnana is understanding of what is revealed by the Shruti using what? Using words. So, each and every word is analyzed. So, nothing is left to doubt. Then the question as to how can you have the divisions, Triputi or any division. Because Jnana in Siddhanta is Chaitanya. Jnanam to Siddhante Chaitanyam eva. So, in that case, Chaitanya, how can you have Bheda? In Chaitanya, you cannot have Veda. Chaitanya is one. So there, Pramatru, Pramana, Prama and Prameya Chaitanyas are there. In Vedanta Siddhanta itself, for understanding, four divisions are made. And then those are looked into. Pramatru, Pramana, Pramiti and Prameya Chaitanya. Then each of these have to be defined. Chaitanya is known. But Pramatru, Pramana, Pramiti and Prama have to be, Prameya have to be understood. They are defined. Sorry. So they have to be defined. And they are defined as per the Vadas. So Avacheda Vada Ritya Pramatru Sakshino Swarupam. There, in each of these, Avacheda Vada, and then we looked at Abhasa Vada. What is the definition of Pramata? So looking at Pramata definition, Antakkarana Vishishta Chaitanya is Pramata in Avacheda Vada, and that is a Jiva, Karta Bhokta Jiva. Whereas Sakshi is defined as Antakkarana Upahita Chaitanya. Means Sakshi has Antakkarana as an Upadhi, whereas Pramata has Antakkarana as a Visheshana. So Visheshana, Vishishta, all these words have to be understood. Now what is Visheshana? That is also defined. What is Upadhi? That is also defined. And related words there. So, Parichedya, Vyavartya, Visheshyam, all these. Upadhi Lakshana has been defined. What is Upadhi? So, these are definitions of what has already been used. So that you know who is a Sakshi, who is a Pramata, who I am really. In that inquiry, all this is needed. When you do Manana, these questions will come up. And they have to be resolved. So, many people, so these words are, you know, Sakshi, Pramata, all these words are loaded words. What exactly is it? Because in Siddhanta, everything is Chaitanya, but that Chaitanya is qualified. How did the divisions in Chaitanya come about? They are all Vyavharika divisions, but the Vyavharika explanation has to be given now. As to how did this division come about? In a sense, what is the difference? You have to know the differences by definition. So there is some definition we have to give for each and every divided, so-called divided Chaitanya. In those divisions, words which have been used, they have to be defined. And that is what is going on here. And then the comparison will be given as to Pramata as defined in Avachedavada versus Pramata as defined in Abhasavada, which is better. So yesterday we closed by saying Abhasavada Ritya Jiva Sakshano Swarupam, and it is Abhasavadasya Jayastvam. Abhasavada has superiority in definitions. Why? Because Abhasa Saita Antakkarana Vishishta Chaitanya is Pramata in Abhasavada. And who is Sakshi there? Abhasa Saita Antakkarana Upahita Chaitanya is Sakshi. So the Abhasa Saita is further qualifying the Antakkarana, which is not the case in Avachedavada. So what is the issue there? In Vyavahara, what is used? Vyavahara Nama. What is Vyavahara also? Vyavahara is Pratiti and Kathana. Whatever appears and narrating that is called as Vyavahara. Even that much has been defined in the work. So why is Abhasavada superior? Because it uses the definition of Pramata, where Antakkarana is further qualified by Abhasa Sahita, having an Abhasa. Why is it better? Abhasavade Antakkaranam Abhasa Sahitam. Avachedavade Tadrahitam Chabhavati. This much we have seen. Dvayor Madhye Abhasavado Jayan. Abhasavada is superior among the two. Why so? Bhashyakaraihi Abhasavada Eva Svikrutaha. Because Bhagavan Bhashyakara accepts Abhasavada alone. Pratibimba is another name, or some differences are there. So Pratibimba Vada can also be considered as same as Abhasavada. There are few technical differences. But Avachheda Vada has an issue which we'll see further. Avachheda Vade Vidyaranya Munayo Dosham Api Ahuhu. In Avachheda Vada, Bhagavan Panchadashikara shows flaws. Podadus tathahi Abhasa Raita Antakkarana Avachinna Chaitanyasya Pramatrutva Vyupagame Ghatavachinna Chaitanyasya Api Pramatrutva Prasajyeta. Who is Jiva? Pramata is Jiva. Nyata, Manta, Shrota, called as Pramata. Who is that one that has Antakkarana? Chaitanya is manifest as this prapancha, entire prapancha. So Chaitanya is not lacking anywhere. What makes a difference between Jiva and Ajiva? Sentient entity and insentient stone, etc. What makes a difference? Antakkarana makes a difference. This is how we explain generally. But if you analyze the technicality of definition, Antakkarana Avachinna Chaitanya is Pramata. Chaitanya is everywhere, Antakkarana is not present everywhere. So this is the definition given by Avachedavada. Abhasa Rahita is an additional qualification. Then Abhasa Rahita Antakkarana Avachinna Chaitanyasya Pramatrutva Abhyupagame. If we accept the further qualification of Abhasa Rahita Antakkarana Avachinna Chaitanya as Pramatva, there is an issue there. Abhasa Rahita, yeah, not Sahita. I may have misread it. So Rahita. Or if I read it, I got confused. Sahita. So definition in Abhasa Vada is Abhasa Sahita Antakkarana. And if you don't qualify the Antakkarana with Abhasa Sahita, then what is that Antakkarana? Abhasa Rahita. So that is the contrast given. The word is not used. Abhasa Rahita is not used. But that is what it means. If you do not qualify it by Abhasa Sahita, then the Antakkarana can be Abhasa Rahita also. So that Antakkarana with or without Abhasa, delimiting the Chaitanya, that becomes pramata if you accept that, meaning avachhedavada. If you accept that, then ghatavachinna chaitanyasyapi pramatrutvam prasajyeta. Then ghatavachinna chaitanya can also become pramata, meaning ghata can also become jiva. How so? Yataha antakarana vat ghata api bhutakaryam. What is the difference between antakarana and ghata? So this is the argument. This is our purva paksha to our as in vivarna. Vivarna will, you can imagine that vivarna is placing a purva paksha to bhamati. Antakarana, what is the difference between antakarana and the bhutakarya, any bhutakarya? Antakarana vat ghata api bhutakarya. Antakarana is also bhutakarya. Ghata is also bhutakarya. So we can use tarka. So this shushka tarka. Is it bhutakarya? So bhutakaryatvat. We'll say bhutakaryatvat ghata api pramata. Why? Bhutakaryatvat antakarana vat. Like an antakarana. Antakarana is bhutakarya. So ghata also is bhutakarya. So with that similarity, antakarana avachinna chaitanya or bhutakarya avachinna chaitanya will mean the same thing. If it means the same thing, then ghata api, ghatasya api pramatrittvam prasajyeta. Ghata can also become pramata. Antakaranam yatha chaitanyasya avachedakam athava vyavartakam. Because the definition is what? Vidyamanatvam. Is ghata there? Yes. Is it a vyavartaka? Yes. It will differentiate akasha. So it can differentiate, it will differentiate chaitanya also. Akasha is differentiated by ghata in the definition itself. It may be an upadhi or it may be a visheshana. For chaitanya, if it becomes a visheshana, then it will become pramata. If it is an upadhi, then it's a sakshi. That chaitanya is a pramata or a sakshi. So thereby, what will happen is that antakarana is bhutakarya, whether stula, sukshma, this argument can come later. Just like anything that we see, science says that we see nothing but light. The reflected light is what we see. Similarly, the chaitanya reflects in bhutakarya. So it may be reflecting. If it is reflecting or not reflecting, that will make a jiva or not a jiva, jiva or ajiva. So reflection is what will make or break, not a bhutakarya. So with that angle, antakarana yatha chaitanyasya avachedakam athva vyavartakam tatha ghatopi chaitanyasya avachedako vyavartakascha. Just like antakarna is a avachedaka and vyavartaka for chaitanya. Similarly, ghata is also avachedaka and vyavartaka. Because we say ghata avachinna chaitanya. We say ghata avachinna chaitanya as well. Prameya avachinna chaitanya, visheya avachinna chaitanya. So ghata is a visheya. So we'll have ghata avachinna chaitanya. So it is a avachedaka as well as vyavartaka. Tasmad antakarna vishishta chaitanyam iva ghatavachinna chaitanyam api pramata bhaved ityapattihi apariharya. If somebody objects to this, we are just pointing out, this is the dosha. If someone objects to this, we cannot remove the so-called apatti. It cannot be resolved. Because antakarna is bhutakarya. Ghata is also bhutakarya. Ghata is an example. Anything is a bhutakarya in the jagat. So it will become a vyavartaka as well as avachedaka of chaitanya. That being so, there is no difference between antakarana being a vyavartaka and avachedaka. Thereby, there is no difference between antakarana vishishta or antakarna upaita chaitanya versus ghata vishishta or ghata upaita chaitanya. There is similarity.
And if you define that as pramata, then on the vishaya side, ghata side also, there can be chaitanya, there can be pramata. And thereby ghata will become a jiva. Ghata is not a jiva. Then what is the difference? Antakkarane abhasasya angikaretu na asya doshasya avakasha. If you qualify the antakkarana further by saying it as abhasa sahita antakkarana, then you know that abhasa can take place only in some particular bhutakarya. Not in any bhutakarya, some particular bhutakarya. Now this is, you know, hair splitting. We can always say that, no, antakkarana is a particular type of bhutakarya. It is not any bhutakarya, it is a specific bhutakarya. If you say that, then might as well add some qualification. And if you are adding some qualification for antakkarana, why not add abhasa? So that is where abhasa vada is coming from. Tatha hi antakkarana pancha tanmatra samashti sattva guna karyatva swacham. Antakkarana is swacha. Why? Because it is panchatanmatra samashti sattva guna karya. It is created out of sattva guna of the total panchamatras. All the panchamahabhutas have sattva, rajas and tamo guna. So there sattva guna karya is antakkarana. Therefore it is swachha. घटादयः पंचीकृत पंचभूत तमोगुण कार्यत्वात् अस्वच्छः. दिस प्रपंच इज क्रिएटेड, स्थूल प्रपंच घटादि स्थूल प्रपंच इज क्रिएटेड बाय द ग्रॉसिफाइड पंचीकृत पंचभूत. एंड व्हाट एग्जैक्टली आउट ऑफ दैट? द तमोगुण. सो तमोगुण कार्य इज दिस प्रपंच, देयरफॉर अस्वच्छ. नाउ वेयर if the water also or darpana, if you compare, if it is swachha, it will have reflection, a clear reflection. If it is aswachha, it will not have pratibimba or avasa. Yat swacham tatra avasaha athava pratibimbo jayate. So antakkarana being swachha, in the antakkarana there can be pratibimba or avasa. Maline padarthe ghatade mani ghatado मलिने पदार्थे आभासु न जायते. इन घटादि देर कैन नॉट बी एन आभासा. व्हाई? बिकॉज इट इज मलिन पदार्थ, बिकॉज ऑफ बी तमोगुण कार्य. दर्पणस्य तत्पिधायक कोशस्य च मृत्कार्यत्व विशेषेपि स्वच्छे दर्पणे मुखस्य आभास प्रतीयते. दर्पणस्य तत्पिधायक कोशस्य च मृत कार्यत्व विशेषे. देयर शुड बी एन आर हियर. सो दर्पण एज वेल एज यू नो तत्पिधायक दी दैट विच कवर्स दी दर्पण, मे बी समथिंग एल्स, यू नो एनीथिंग एल्स अदर देन दर्पण, वी कैन टेक समथिंग अदर देन कोश. सो इट्स अ कवरिंग. सो हियर यू शुड बी हैव एन आकार. सो मृत्कार्यत्वाविशेषे ऑल्दो देयर इज अविशेषा इन दर्पण एंड तत्पिधायक कोश, दर्पण पिधायक कोश दैट विच कंसील्स द दर्पण ऑल्सो. यू नो यू हैव दर्पण इन अ यू नो इन अ क्लोज्ड यू नो सम कपबोर्ड वेयर दर्पण इज इनसाइड. Some kind of a comparison can be given. So darpana reflects, but the cupboard does not reflect. You have to open the cupboard, look at the darpana, then only darpana will reflect. But the kosha does not reflect. But both are mrutkarya. Both are created from mrut. Darpana is created from mrut, and the kosha is also created from mrut. So therefore, mrutkaryatva avisheshe api. Even if both are mrutkarya, still swachhe darpane mukasya abhasa pratiyate, aswachhe darpana pidayaka koshetu na mukasya abhasa pratiyate. In swachha darpana there will be mukha pratibimba, whereas in the kosha which is aswachha, you will not have pratibimba. Evameva, similarly is the comparison with the exemplified sattva guna karyatva swachhe antakarane chaitanya abhasa pratiyate. Tamo guna karyatva aswachhe shariradau ghatadau cha chaitanya abhaso na pratiyate. So antakarana being a sattva guna karya, there will be chaitanya abhasa pratiti in antakarana. So you'll have pratibimba in antakarana, abhasa in antakarana of the chaitanya, whereas in sharira, stula sharira and ghatadi prapancha jagat, there won't be chaitanya abhasa. Why? Because of being aswachha. Why aswachha? Tamoguna karyatvat. Yeah, because it is created from the panchikrita panchamahabhuta tamoguna. So this is the reason that antakarana will have abhasa. To this, Bhamatikara raises an objection. So he says, no pratibimba vada, abhasa vada. You cannot have abhasa or pratibimba of chaitanya. Of everything else you can have abhasa or pratibimba. But chaitanya has no guna. How will it reflect? So this we have already answered. I mean, sadhu has already answered in earlier itself. He says, Shabda. Shabda itself is a guna. Can Shabda have guna? Nirguna Brahma Chaitanya cannot reflect. This is your aropa. Now we ask a counter question. Is Shabda a guna? Yes. Shabda is a guna of Akasha. So Shabda itself is a guna. What does Shabda have? Shabda is a guna, not a guni. Akasha is a guni which has Shabda as guna. Now, Shabda not being a guni, can it have guna? No, guna cannot have a guna. Then, Shabda should not reflect. But there is echo. Echo is reflection of Shabda. You may be thinking that the reflection may be only of a particular type. Just like akara is a form. This is a misunderstanding. Akara is in keeping with something else. That is akara. Following something else. It may be shabdakara also. It need not be rupakara only. So when we say ghatakara vritti, there ghata is an akara of a form. But when you say shabdakara, rasakara vritti, shabdakara vritti, there the vritti cannot be understood as having a form. Need not be a form as a shape. There is no shape to Shabda per se. There is no shape to Rasa ityadi. So Shabda sparsha Rupa Rasa Gandha, there the example of Rupa is given when we talk about Ghatakara Vritti. But it has to be extended to everything else. It may be a little subtle, difficult to understand, but still, if you understand that the vritti is in keeping with the vishaya. That vishaya can be rupa also, shabda also, sparsha, rasa, gandha, it can be anything. So akara should not be misunderstood literally as being a shape. Similarly, you need not think that pratibimba will take place only when there is a guna. Not only guni can have a pratibimba, but guna can also have a pratibimba because it is pratyaksha in the anubhava of echo. Shabda pratidhvani is there. So shabda itself being a guna, it cannot be a shabdi again or a guni again. So shabdi akasha, but shabda is what reflects. That reflection is not of light, it is of Shabda, which is a guna. So if it is possible for a nirguna Shabda to reflect, why can't nirguna Chaitanya reflect? So that's the answer. So nirguna Chaitanya can also reflect. Thereby we answer the Bhamatikara also. And in the comparison, सिंस घटा कैन ऑल्सो बिकम घटादि प्रपंच कैन ऑल्सो बिकम प्रमाता विच इज डिजास्ट्रस टू सिद्धांत देर फोर इट इज बेटर टू टेक टू आभासवाद इफ अवच्छेदवाद इज सफिशियंट फॉर अवर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ ऐक्य वी कैन स्टे देर देर इज नो कंपल्शन टू स्विच टू आभासवाद बट इफ समबडी ऑब्जेक्ट टू आभासवाद बिकॉज भामतिकारा केम लेटर If Abhasavada, Pratibimbavada, which has been there in the Sampradaya, if it is objected to, then we also defend it and object further to the different solutions brought in, which may have flaws. We'll show the flaws there. So this is how the process is. We are okay with any prakriya. But if you, you know, bring swords, you know, bring danda, then it is... What is called as Ushtra Laghudana Nyaya. So camel which is carrying some dandas, a load. If the camel misbehaves with the owner, who of course he is putting a load there. In the example, we, you know, should not take literal. The comparison is that the camel who is taking care, the owner who is taking care of the camel, feeding the camel and using it for some purpose. We'll assume that the camel is well taken care of. But if the camel starts misbehaving, then what does he do? He will take the same danda which it is carrying and unfortunately beat the camel with it. So this is the example which is given. This is a nyaya. So if you bring a, you know, if you use your tarka and start objecting and start, you know, misbehaving with these siddhantis, sampradayas, then we'll take the same danda of the nyaya or tarka that you are using and beat you up with it. So this is the process. This is a debate. You know, in a debate, whatever happens, if you object, then it is at that level. You cannot say that, oh, you know, it is everything is chaitanya and deal with that level. You have to get down at that level of the tarka and resolve the tarka with tarka. So this is what is done. Otherwise, prakriya wise, if whatever prakriya, whichever prakriya lands you doubtlessly in aikya, that is fine. So that is the 216th avarta, which says why is abhasavada superior to avachedavada. In the 217th avarta, antakarna gata dvivida prakasha eva pramata na anyaha. Further granularity. There, Chaitanya has Prakasha. Chaitanya itself is Prakasha. We can say Chaitanya itself is Prakasha, but Raho Shiravas Shashti, we can say Chaitanya has Prakasha because it reveals something. Similarly, just like the sun, there is sunlight which is reflecting. Now you put a mirror in front of the sunlight. The sunlight reveals the Ghatapatadi prapancha. It reveals objects. Now, if you put a mirror in front, the mirror will reflect light. Now, that light, if you focus on something, that will also reveal objects because of being of the nature of light. It will not be of the nature of light, but then the reflected light is of the nature of light. Reflected light is of the nature of light, just like the light which is the original light of sun. Sunlight is Prakasha, is a revealer, Prakashaka. So is the reflected light Prakashaka. So in the exemplified, there is Chaitanya Prakasha, and then now you are saying that there is Pratibimba or Abhasa. That will also be Prakashavat. So, antakarna gata divida prakasha. There are two prakashas now. One is the Chaitanya prakasha and there is Abhasa prakasha or Pratibimba prakasha. Saha eva pramata. Divida prakasha eva pramata. Na anyaha. So, you have to have pramata. For pramatrittvam to be there has to be Chaitanya and there has to be Abhasa also. Pratibimba also, because Chaitanya is everywhere. Chaitanya being everywhere, everything does not become pramata. Then what becomes pramata? We say antakarana vishishta becomes pramata. Okay, antakarana vishishta becomes pramata, then bhutakaryatvat ghatadi api pramata. Because ghatadi vishishta chaitanya pramata. That is resolved by qualifying antakarana further as abhasa saita antakarana vishishta chaitanyam pramata. Once you say that, then abhasa is also prakashavat, prakashavan. Chaitanya is also prakashavan. These are the two prakashas now. Prakashavan, to explain that, they are prakashavat. They have prakasha, or they are of the nature of prakasha. They will take swarthe. Raho shiravat shakti. Then, dvivida prakashaya pramata, antakkarana gata. So, in antakkarana, you will find two types of prakashas now. One is the original Chaitanya prakasha, other is the reflected Chaitanya prakasha. Na anyaha pramata bhavati. Ittham antakkarane dvivida prakashavasti. Ekaha vyapaka chaitanyasya prakashaha, aparaha abhasa rupa chaitanyasya prakasha. So, we have seen this. There are two types of prakashas now. Even the Chaitanya will reveal, because it's of the nature of revelation, as well as abhasa chaitanya will reveal because of following the chaitanya, mimicking, claiming a false chaitanyatvam, sentience. Sentience reveals, just like the reflected light will also reveal objects in its presence, so also the abhasa chaitanya will reveal. Sharire ghatadishu cha vyapaka chaitanyasya prakasha eka eva asti. So, sharire ghatadishu cha. In the sharira. Sharira, what is sharira? Stula sharira is nothing but part of prapancha. Of course, antakarana is also part of prapancha. Because it is created. It is put together. It's an assemblage. So, just like ghata, sharira is also assembled. Ghatadi is also assembled for the jiva. Just like sharira is assembled for the jiva, ghatadi is also assembled for the jiva. Why? Because it's a bhogya prapancha. If not for one jiva, for another jiva. Everything that is created has value for one or the other jiva. Because jagat is created in keeping with the sum total of karmas of all jivas at that point of time. Whatever karma is due for fructification at any point of time, that is the nature of the prapancha. That is the kind of prapancha which is put together by Ishvara. But in Sharira, there is Tadatmya Sambandha of Jiva. There, the Sharira becomes a subject as though. Then Ghatadi becomes an object, Bhogya Prapancha. Although Sharira is also Bhogya, it will become the Jiva itself by Tadatmya Sambandha. One claims Sharira to be oneself, all the Sharira Dharmas to be oneself. But one does not claim the Ghata to be oneself or its Dharmas to be oneself. One claims Ghata to be mine, object, mine or someone else's. But Mamakara can be there, but in Sharira, Ahankara is there. That is the only difference. Otherwise, Sharira is also Bhutakarya, Ghatadi is also Bhutakarya. Whether Sharira is Stula or Sukshma. But when Sharira, the word is used. Just a moment. Sorry. So when Sharira word is used without qualifying it as Sukshma or Stula, then it means Stula. Therefore, Stula Sharire Ghatadishu cha Vyapaka Chaitanyasya Prakasha Eka Eva Asti. Because Chaitanya, Moola Chaitanya, Brahma Chaitanya is all pervasive. Isha Vasyam Idam Sarvam. Therefore, all of this, Idam Sarvam, Shariram, Ghatadi, Sarvam, has Vyapaka Chaitanya, Prakasha. But that is the only Prakasha it has. Eka Eva Asti. Dvitiyaha Abhasasya Prakasho Nasti. There is no Abhasa because it is not Abhasa Sahita. Sharira is Abhasa Rahita. Ghatadi is Abhasa Rahita. देयरफॉर आभासस्य प्रकाश शरीरे घटादिषु च नास्ति तस्मात् देयरफॉर द्विविध प्रकाश सहित अंतकरण विशिष्ट चैतन्यम एव प्रमाता इत्युच्यते. सो नाउ द प्रमाता डेफिनेशन इज फर्दर रिफाइंड. हु इज अ प्रमाता? चैतन्यम प्रमाता. व्हाट काइंड ऑफ चैतन्य? अंतकरण विशिष्ट चैतन्यम प्रमाता. ओके, अंतकरण विशिष्ट चैतन्य प्रमाता. अंतकरण इज भूत कार्य, सो इज घटादि शरीर भूत कार्य, so that can also be pramata. No, we'll say abhasa sahita antakarana. Abhasa is prakasha, so prakasha sahita abhasa sahita antakarana visishta chaitanyam eva pramata. But then prakasha is there everywhere. If you say prakasha, but prakasha is what here? Abhasa prakasha. Therefore abhasa prakasha, and to include that not only abhasa prakasha, the chaitanya which is there, that also has to be included, moola chaitanya. Otherwise abhasa it will not take place. But abhasa, if it takes place, we have to explain that abhasa, wherever there is abhasa, the chaitanya is also there. It is unlike, you know, the sun being somewhere else and you hold a mirror, there is a reflection of the sun in the mirror. The sun is elsewhere. So you don't talk about the sun in your room. You talk about the reflected light in your room. That's all. It is unlike that. Reflected light is there. Is the sun there? Sun isn't there. Sun is elsewhere. Here it isn't so. So you have to, there can be a doubt. Oh, prakasha is a chaitanya prakasha, chaitanya, brahma chaitanya, tatpadartha, somewhere else. Just like surya, suryavat, tatpadartha, kutrachidapi asti. आभासस्तु अत्र एव अंतकरणे वर्तते. सो आभास इज देयर अंतकरण. आभास चैतन्य इज देयर इन द अंतकरण, बट चैतन्य इज एल्सवेयर. इफ दैट इज द डाउट, इट इजंट सो, दैट इज रिजॉल्व्ड बाय दिस डेफिनेशन. द्विविध प्रकाश सहित अंतकरण विशिष्ट चैतन्यमेव प्रमाता इत्युच्यते. नाउ यू कैन नॉट हैव अ डाउट दैट सूर्यवत् तत्पदार्थ कुत्रचिदपि अस्ति. नतु एक प्रकाश मात्र सहित घटादि विशिष्ट चैतन्यम प्रमाता. हाउएवर घटादि विशिष्ट चैतन्य विल नॉट बी प्रमाता बिकॉज इट हैज एक प्रकाश. चैतन्य इज देयर इन घटा ऑल्सो, बट देयर इज नो आभास प्रकाश. देयरफॉर द्विविध प्रकाश घटादि विशेषु नास्ति. देयर बाय you will not have pramatrutvam in eka prakasha matra sahita ghatadi vishishta chaitanya. So this is how the differentiation is done between jiva and ajiva. Yesham mate antakarane abhasu nasti, tesham mate ghatadau iva antakaranam api antakarane api. So the last letter has to be guessed. Yesham mate. So in Abhasa Vada, what has been explained versus Avachheda Vada. So Yesham Mate Avachheda Vade. That's the idea there. Antakarane Abhasu Nasti. Abhasa isn't there, Pratibimba isn't there, Antakarana. Tesham Mate Ghatadav Iva. Like in Ghatadi Jagat. Antakarane Api Dvitiya Abhasasya Prakashu Nasti. In Ghatadi also, Prapancha, there is one Chaitanya, Moola Chaitanya Prakasha. And in Antakkarana also there is one Moola Chaitanya Prakasha. There is no Abhasa Prakasha. Apicha yaha ekaha vyapaka chaitanyasya prakashaha antakkarane asti sa eva ghatadu api asti. So there is only one vyapaka chaitanya which is all pervasive, Moola Chaitanya. That is there in Antakkarana just like it is there in ghata. Tasmad antakkarana vishishta chaitanyasya प्रमातृत्वांगीकारे घट विशिष्टस्य शरीर विशिष्टस्य कुड्य विशिष्टस्य चैतन्यस्य प्रमातृत्वं कुड्य विशिष्टस्य च, यू कैन ऐड च हियर मे बी, च चैतन्यस्य प्रमातृत्वं स्वीकर्तव्यं भवेत्. सो यू हैव टू एक्सेप्ट प्रमातृत्वं फॉर एवरीथिंग बिकॉज एक्चुअली घट विशिष्टस्य as opposed to antakarana vishishta, you will have ghata vishishta, sharira vishishta, kudya vishishta, anything you can take, sarva vishishta, in fact. Anything that is karya. So you can say bhuta karya vishishtasya sarvasya chaitanyasya pramatrutvam sikartavyam bhavet. You will have to accept pramatrutvam for everything. If it is a bhuta karya and chaitanya being everywhere, it will be visheshana to, it will have visheshana of everything, anything and everything. Then anything and everything which is bhuta karya, being a visheshana to chaitanya, segmenting the chaitanya as though, will claim pramatrutvam. By definition, ittham ghata shariradhyapekshaya antakkarne idr vailakshanyam asti. So this kind of vailaksha difference is there in ghata shariradi apekshaya antakkarne. What kind of difference is there? There has to be a difference of abhasa being there. Atracha ayam hetuhu. What is the reason for differentiation? It has been said briefly. He is explaining further. Sattva guna karyatvad antakkaranam swacham. Ata eva tachaitanya abhasa grahana yogyancha. There can be abhasa in antakkarana because it is sattva guna karya and therefore swacha. He has mentioned this earlier. Itara padarthastu. Sharira, ghatadi, sharira, kudyadi, all these that have been explained earlier. Anything that you take other than antakkarana, which is sattva guna karya, they are all tamoguna karya. Itara padarthastu. Tamoguna karyatvat aswachaha. Ata eva te chaitanyavasa grahana yogyascha. Grahana yogyascha. Grahana ayogya. Being tamoguna karya, they are aswacha. Being aswacha, they cannot have chaitanyavasa. So they are unfit to have chaitanya abhasa. Abhasa grahana yogyata, abhasa grahana yogya antakkarana vishishta chaitanyam meva pramata iti abhidiyate. Antakkarana being swachha due to being sattva guna karya alone can have, is capable of having abhasa and therefore it is capable of becoming pramata. And that is the reason it is called as pramata, not the others who are other things which are incapable of having an abhas of chaitanya because of being aswacha. Why are they aswacha? Because of being tamoguna karya. Natu abhasa grahana ayogya ghatadi vishishta chaitanyam pramata bhavati. Cannot be pramata because of being tamo guna karya and aswacha, they are incapable of abhasa grahana. Ata eva abhasa vadha shreyan. Therefore, abhasa vadha is superior natu avachheda vadha. There is a tippana here. So, Swamiji clarifies there. Abhasa vadhe abhasasya swarupam adhikataya kalpaniyam bhavati. In abhasa vadha, Gauravam. There is Gauravam. You have to add additional units to define. To explain the Abhasa Swarupa, you have to keep on adding some things more and more. And you know, it becomes a long definition. So there is Gauravam. You know, there are more words used. You have to use the simplest way out. So Avachedavada is simpler in that manner. Avachedavade na ittham yadyapi Abhasavade Gauravam. Although there is Gaurava in Abhasavada, Avachedavade Laghamcha. Avachedavada is quite simple in that manner. Tathapi, Manda Jidnyasur, Buddhu Abhasavada Sputam Arudaha Bhavet. But Abhasavada will take away all doubts for Manda Adhikari. Manda Jidnyasur, somebody who does not have more into, does not want to make comparison, comparative study, etc. There, tathapi manda jidnyaso buddhau abhasavada sputam arudha bhavet. It will clarify all doubts. It will explain more and more, thereby the abhasavada will suit everyone. It will एक्सप्लेन एवरीथिंग इन डिटेल इत्यनेन अभिप्रायेण आभासवाद स्तूयते सो इन स्तुति ऑफ आभासवाद वी नीड नॉट कंसीडर्ड एज इदमित्तम दिस इज व्हाट स्वामीजी सेज वी बोथ वादास आर ओके दैट्स द आइडिया भाष्यकारादीनामपि अयमेव आशयः सो भगवान भाष्यकार और टीकाकार विद्यारण्याचार्य व्हेनेवर दे स्पीक अबाउट आभासवाद एज बेटर देन दे हैव द सेम आइडिया इन माइंड दैट इट इज ईजियर टू अंडरस्टैंड इट विल गिव मोर क्लैरिटी बिकॉज इट विल गो इन टू लॉट ऑफ डिटेल्स सो ईदर वे विच एवर वर्क्स दैट इज ओके दैट्स वॉट ही इज सेइंग फर्दर 218th वी लुक एट इन दी नेक्स्ट पाठ प्रमात्रादि चतुर्विध चैतन्य स्वरूपम सो दि स्वरूप ऑफ प्रमाता प्रमाण इत्यादि आर गोइंग टू बी लुक्ड इनटू नेक्स्ट सुखम नित्यम सप्रकाशम व्यापकं नाम रूप अधिष्ठानं बुद्धि बोध्यं बुद्धिरूपेत्न निर्मपारं सर्व वेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्येक परमः तदेव अन्नमत्तम् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः नमस्ते आई विल सी यू इन द नेक्स्ट पाठ
हरि ओम.